morning, dear all. I'm Dr. Srujal Shah. I'm a vascular and endovascular surgeon. We do a lot of venous ulcer treatment and we manage chronic venous insufficiencies. So today we are going to demonstrate compression bandaging method, how to apply a long stretch elastic bandage for this patient, Mr. Baldev Bhai. He is a young gentleman who had a chronic venous ulcer of 7 years duration and it was non-healing. We did debridement, then we did a skin grafting. The most important thing for maintenance of these kind of limbs is compression. When patient learns to how to apply bandage properly, those kind of patients manage very well. And we will show you how to apply a bandage in a proper manner. Compression therapy can be given by two methods. One is compression stockings and second is bandages. Why stockings are not easy for all patients? Because these kind of patients, many a time they are obese and the anatomy of their foot is distorted and they are not able to use the stockings properly. So they end up either not using it or they bring out some complications after using stockings. So in case of venous ulcers, once we treat them, we recommend to use bandages. Now bandages are of two kind. One is short stretch bandage and other are long stretch or elastic bandages. Today we will be showing you elastic bandages. Usually what happens when we ask the patient to use bandage, they say the bandage gets slipped out from the lower edge and the clips get lost. So this company has come out with an innovation that they have made a pocket in the lower part which fits into the foot part, and they have also brought a velcro. So high grip VC is very patient friendly and I am going to demonstrate how to apply it. There are certain technical points which you should keep in mind when we are applying the elastic compression bandage. That patient should not be having peripheral arterial disease. We have to ask the patient whether he feels pain on both these bony prominences as well as this area where tibialis anterior tendon is there and on the heel. If you apply too much pressure, these areas may get necrosed and patient will have secondary complications. So it is very important how to apply. Now we are going to apply. The one more thing, the foot has to be, ankle has to be in 90 degree angle so that the proper pressure will be applied to the limb. We are going to apply it now. So this pocket, it will go like this. Once you have put it properly, we'll start wrapping it. Now, we have to apply 50% stretch and it should be 50% overlapping in each wrap. That will give optimum pressure. This is a 4 meter bandage which will come up to below knee length. There are 8 meter bandages also if we are planning to apply for above knee or thigh length. Now there is a velcro here. The main advantage of this velcro is you don't have to apply safety pin or clips which usually patient loses and then they don't apply it. So last round has to be like this and we are done. After applying this, we have to again ask the patient to wait for 10 minutes, walk around and say if there is too much pressure, we may loosen it up if patient feels a lot of pain. Thank you. So as we discussed, there are two methods of applying compression therapy, stockings and bandages. And we prefer stockings for those patients who have normal anatomy and who can wear stockings. But for most of the patients having venous ulcer due to their disability or the distortion in anatomy or the desired pressure what we want to give, we usually advise bandages. Now in bandages, there are two main variants, short stretch and long stretch. Long stretch or elastic bandages have certain advantages, we will discuss that. First of all, stretch provides pressure and not the calf movements. So elastic bandages are better even if the patient is bedridden, the pressure will be given to that. Stiffness is low, so patient compliance is more. It can be applied by self and you may not need a person to apply that. Pressure is maintained for long duration. When the patient stands, the pressure will increase by 8 to 10 millimeter, that will further add to the therapy. And the technique is very easy as we already demonstrated. Now, what are the contraindications of stretch bandages or elastic bandages? When the patient has peripheral arterial disease, as we discussed in scientific terms, ankle brachial index less than 0.8, we should not give very tight or elastic bandage that can produce necrosis in the skin pressure areas. When the patient has uncompensated cardiac failure, you should not apply these elastic bandages. When patient has sepsis or phlebitis, we should not apply these bandages. Otherwise, they are very patient friendly and we have got very good results in our patients. Over the last 6 to 7 years, we have been routinely applying. Patient initially resist and they say that we can't apply or we have already applied. But when you counsel them, when you explain them how to use it, and then when they feel it for initial 1 or 2 weeks and they get result, they are very happy and they are very motivated to use them. Even those black patches of chronic venous insufficiency, that pigmentation comes down to normal with the regular use of elastic bandages. So usually people ask us, what are the indications of using compression bandages? Usually what we have seen, the chronic venous congestive pain is relieved when you apply compression bandage because deep and superficial veins get decompressed. That is always a multimodality approach. We give venotonic drugs like Deflon also. We apply these bandages for varicose veins, moderate to severe venous diseases, that is stage 2 to 6 of venous diseases. Those edematous limbs where bandages will help in reducing edema also. Even for lymphatic edema also, these bandages are going to help. There is no single modality treatment for leg edema or venous insufficiency. You have to apply all the modalities together and do counseling for better outcomes. So when we are managing chronic venous insufficiency, stage 4, 5 or 6 of venous insufficiency, we usually explain the patient that he needs to follow certain points. The first important thing is compression therapy, that is in form of bandage. Second thing is leg elevation at night. Third thing is improving the calf pumping, that is calf exercise. We usually recommend that 1 minute 5 to 10 times a day is important. That will reduce the venous congestion. And the fourth thing is medicines. When the patients feel that only medicines are going to act, they will not get the results. So we have to emphasize and we explain the patient that they need to do serious work to get better results. So I'm going to discuss a case. A young male who was an obese patient who underwent varicose vein laser for a small ulcer on the lateral aspect of the foot. And he underwent EVLT plus sclerotherapy. He underwent even sclerotherapy for the second time, but he was not properly counseled and advised compression therapy. The 1 cm ulcer became almost a 1 ft ulcer, and patient was suffering with that ulcer, which is foul smelling, severely tender, painful and infected for almost 7 years when he approached us. After initial evaluation and Doppler scan, we decided to go for debridement. We debrided it and we did a skin grafting for better ulcer healing. Once the ulcer is healed, we have put the patient on compression bandage, and almost last whole 7 to 8 months, patient is doing so well that the ulcer is healed, the skin color is improving, patient's limb edema has gone totally, and patient compliance is extremely well. So this is a live example. We will be showing the photographs that these kind of patients can be motivation for a lot of patients who are suffering from chronic venous diseases. So ever since we started vascular surgery, we are working to salvage limbs to prevent amputation, and the goal is to save limbs and lives. So let's work all together to save thousands, millions of limbs. In our country, a lot of limbs are amputated on a daily basis due to unavailability of proper treatment. So I would suggest all of us to get into this noble cause and work for limb salvation.